you were in charge during a lot of this, sir. Yeah, and in fact, you signed the FISA applications.
Sure, I think I signed at least two or three of them. He doesn't conclude that there was intentional misconduct by these career special agents.
No, he just says it's one of two things and he can't decide. Gross negligence or it was intentional misconduct. Well, that's what he said.
I've read his report. He says we are not concluding that there was intentional misconduct by FBI.
Did you hear what he just said here?
Only a week after James Comey hilariously claims to have been vindicated by the IG report, he's now apparently launched a campaign to spin his crimes as nothing more than a clerical error. Appearing on Fox News with Chris Wallace, Comey unconvincingly tries to minimize the severity of his corrupt and illegal use of FISA.
You have been taking something of a victory lap since the IG report was released earlier this week. The question is whether or not it's justified.
Do you think this is vindication?
It is.
Does your report vindicate Mr. Comey?
It doesn't vindicate anyone at the FBI who touched this, including the leadership.
The IG says you should feel no vindication.
Well, maybe it turns upon how we understand the word.
No, I don't think so. Everybody has the same understanding of the word vindication. Vindication is the act of clearing somebody of blame or suspicion. Horowitz was quite clear that anybody involved in that FISA process is not vindicated. Comey oversaw these abuses and even signed off on falsified documents.
You were in charge during a lot of this, sir. And in fact, you signed the FISA applications.
He lied to FISA and he lied to the press. People around Trump are in prison right now for supposedly lying to the FBI. So how does Comey avoid that standard?
Gross negligence, or they intended to do it. They intended to lie to the FISA court. You were in charge during a lot of this, sir. And in fact, you signed the FISA applications.
Sure, I think I signed at least two or three of them. He doesn't conclude that there was intentional misconduct by these career special agents.
We also noted the lack of satisfactory explanations and, in fact, leave open the possibility that, for the reasons you indicated, it's unclear what the motivations were. On the one hand, gross incompetence, negligence. On the other hand, intentionality.
That's what he said.
I've read his report. He says we are not concluding that there was intentional misconduct by FBI.
Did you hear what he just said here?
I did. I don't know the context of that. I've read.
He was asked specifically, how do you explain it? And he said gross negligence or intentionality.
Yeah. Well, I'm sorry. He doesn't find intentionality.
Leave open the possibility that, for the reasons you indicated, it's unclear what the motivations were. On the one hand, gross incompetence, negligence. On the other hand, intentionality?
No. As Wallace correctly points out, Horowitz was asked this question directly and stated that he didn't conclude for certain, but that it was either gross negligence or intentional. Comey's body language seems to give him away. His eyes are darting around, and he just seems really uncomfortable as Wallace presses him on these questions. I also think part of it is that Wallace is really spelling it out clearly. He's not trying to muddy the waters like the rest of the press is doing. We're really just going to have to wait and see what Durham comes up with. AG Barr already dismissed this conclusion of no bias, saying that the IG has very limited access to the agencies and people. I think what we're seeing here with Comey is someone that's guilty but just sticking with the plan and just responding as if those hearings never happened. I think he's just sort of counting on the fact that half the country hasn't seen the hearings and probably never will. The same with his delusional claim that he's vindicated, despite the fact that Horowitz left no mysteries about it, saying that anybody connected to the FISA process is not vindicated. This arrogant bastard actually said he wouldn't resign if all of this came out while he was still director.
If you were still there and all of this came out and it turned out it happened on your watch, would you resign?
No, I don't think so.
Sorry to interrupt, but Christmas is coming up, and I think I have a good gift idea from PatrioticLegacy.com. PatrioticLegacy.com was nice enough to send me over one of these units so I could give you an honest review. I love this tactical flashlight. It's got everything you would ever need. 6 overall lighting functions, escape features like the window hammer and the seatbelt cutter, solar charging so you don't need batteries, a power bank for charging your phone and other devices, and a removable compass with access to a personal safety alarm. Patriot Legacy supports veterans and YouTubers like yours truly. So head on over there and make sure to use the promo code DRONE20 to get 20% off your purchase. Thank you. I'm really, really, really baffled about how these people are avoiding prosecution for lying to the FISA courts. It's the same with Brennan and McCabe. I mean, McCabe lies and not only doesn't get prosecuted, but gets a job on CNN. Something's just not right here. And like I said, hopefully something comes out of this John Durham report. Don't get excited though, because the DNC media is already pumping out propaganda to soften the blow. For example, this CNN article from 3 hours ago as I'm making this video with the headline, John Durham's investigation into the FBI Russian probe comes into focus. The entire purpose of this article is to discredit Durham's report and to spin the IG report to mitigate any negative impact on the Democrats or the Russia investigation. If this Durham report comes out and contradicts everything the media has been saying for the last few years, they're not going to look very good. So they're heavily invested in this narrative and they're going to protect it at all costs. This article starts spreading misinformation right off the bat, saying, quote, "A clearer picture of the next charged investigation into the FBI's probe of Russian interference in the 2016 election is emerging, and President Donald Trump is already cashing in on suggestions that it could reveal damning accusations of bias by law enforcement and intelligence officials that last week's Inspector General report debunked." You got that? Trump is cashing in, so you know not to trust anything that's going to come out in that report. And there's that talking point that we've been hearing so much in the DNC media, debunked. They claim that the IG report debunked claims of bias, but as you just heard, that's not the case.
Leave open the possibility that, for the reasons you indicated, it's unclear what the motivations were. On the one hand, gross incompetence, negligence. On the other hand, intentionality.
Leave open the possibility. On the one hand, gross incompetence, negligence. On the other hand, intentionality.
I've read his report. He says, we are not concluding that there was intentional misconduct.
To be crystal clear here, nothing was debunked. CNN and anybody else who claims that is just lying. Lastly, I think what you're going to see a lot of is the media and Democrats focusing a lot of attacks on Attorney General William Barr. Former Attorney General Eric Holder recently wrote an op-ed attacking Barr for so-called congressional obstruction and being too close to Trump. CNN, of course, praised this attack, without recounting the fact that Eric Holder himself ignored congressional subpoenas.
Means that Holder thinks he should be removed from office, period. And that is kind of stunning. And by the way, my hand-picked person will soon come out with another report which will say what I want him to say. And so Holder is saying he ought to leave.
When the Republicans tried to hold him in contempt, the Democrats walked out of the vote. And they did it with the drooling, slavish support of the media.
Tell the Republicans to stop this witch hunt now. He's right.
Why go ahead with a contempt vote?
Look, there are certain internal documents that are not Congress's business.
Why?
It just looks like more of our broken politics and vicious fights now out in the open.
A party in the Congress that does just about nothing to create jobs or to help people without jobs decided the best way to do their job is to shower the Obama administration with subpoenas.
Holder also described himself as Obama's wingman, so the idea that he has any room to preach here is absurd. And the fact that CNN would withhold the information that I just gave you shows you that they're just interested in deception. Expect that no matter how bad this report is for the FBI, the media is going to run cover and probably convince at least half the country that it's all nothing but a debunked conspiracy theory. All we can do is to continue to put out content like this and to challenge the DNC media narrative. If you would like to support this channel in that mission, please consider subscribing to me on Patreon, Subscribestar, or just sending a donation on PayPal. Or you can just like, share, and subscribe. However you decide to support this channel, I appreciate it. Thanks, and keep coming back.